June 5th, Monday afternoon. And I'm headed to Barkley, or the West Coast anyway. Just coming out of the marina. So it's 3 weeks on my own, going as far north as I can, and then come back to Port Alberni, pick up Carrie and Natasha and the dog, and then go back out for another 10. And eventually Paul comes along, and we'll do another 10 out there. So back on the 24th or 25th of July. So at the moment, it's me, myself, and I headed out, which is all right. We'll get company soon enough. It's supposed to be showery on Thursday, so I've got 2 days to get out. Royal Vic tonight, more than likely. And then Souk. And then the 70-odd miles to Barkley Sound. This will be the new Victoria to Vancouver Harbour to Harbour ferry. A luxury ferry. 300 plus a seat. Not quite first thing in the morning, it's 5:30 already, but we're on our way. Dodging a few of the crab traps on the way out of Cadboro Bay. Looks pretty flat, which is perfect for what we're trying to do today. Headed for Souk. Get through Ray's Passage before the tide change at 10 o'clock. Seven Seas arriving in Victoria. Early in the morning. Race for rocks on a very calm morning. Just had my usual breakfast of egg muffin. And now it's just a matter of getting to Barkley Sound. Oh, this is Port Renfrew. Decided to head her in here. We got a westerly wind that's supposed to climb to 15 this afternoon. So I'll come in here and either anchor or tie up the marina. We'll figure that out. Okay, so here I sit at Port Renfrew. Nice new marina. No power to the docks and no water at this end. And they still charge me $40, but it's better than the little anchors that used to be here. Got blown in here, the wind started picking up, and it's probably blowing 12 to 15 now from the west. And the current was going to be against me until about now. I have 36 miles to go. So at 5.5 knots, that would be arrival at about midnight, which wasn't my idea of fun. So I came in here instead. We'll leave at 5 in the morning. It is about 4:30. We're headed out of Port San Juan, or Port Renfrew, whatever you want to call it. And it's not exactly a clear morning, but it could be worse. They're calling for rain tonight and light winds this morning, so it's all good. We have 33 miles to go. back in Turtle Island. It's just after noon. I'm the only boat here. The wind is still light, although there's a forecast for a gale tonight from the southwest and southeast, along with rain tonight and showers tomorrow. So it's a good thing I came in today, because if I left it till tomorrow, I would probably still be stuck in soup. This morning when we left, or when I left, it was already blowing 22 knots of race at 4 o'clock, so if I hadn't have gone yesterday and if I hadn't have gone today, I would still be stuck there.
It's raining. It is 29. I've been working on the log, reading a book, finding leaks. The furnace is on. The fresh cinnamon buns out of the oven are great, as is the coffee. So it's going to be an indoors kind of day. Looks like it's supposed to rain all day. Going to turn into scattered showers later this afternoon. It's 10 o'clock in the morning, headed for Yakulet. We're about 3 miles from Yakulet, although we got a little ways to go yet. We've got to go around a bunch of rocks. The wind has picked up to a nice steady 10 to 12. The sun is coming out eventually. We're into the ocean as well, although it's kind of hard to tell on video, I'm sure. Life is good. Good old Yakulet. What you see is what you got. Finished all the laundry, got the shopping done. Time to head for dinner. I think there might still be a hockey game on. As you will note, the ship is gone. Yes, this is what 5 a.m. looks like. Not much going on a Sunday morning. Well, this is going to be fun for 4 hours if I carry on. A bit of a chop on top of big swells, but I think we're in some current flooding out of here. We shall see as we turn the corner. Well, so much for that idea. Pardon me. It's a wee bit too rough out there. Doesn't look like much on video. But when the bow gets buried, it is time to pack up and go back. Well, somewhat disappointing. I'm headed back for Turtle Island. It's the closest secure anchorage. And there's no wind. So I might as well just head back, throw the anchor out,
take a break. Maybe go over to Port Alberni Yacht Club this afternoon if the wind pipes up full speed. That was just too uncomfortable and for a solo sailor going against that kind of crap, not a whole lot of fun. On a much sunnier note, sailing out of Turtle Bay, for lack of a better term, and headed for, I think we'll go to Port Alberni Yacht Club today. We're about halfway across, well, not quite, halfway across the Imperial Eagle Channel. Would you believe it's a southwesterly wind today? Nice breeze, reasonably warm, a couple of sailboats off on the horizon. Not a bad day after a miserable start. Must be something going on somewhere. Someone's putting a lot of work into this place. And not a single boat at the outlet. Am I lonesome here? And it's sunny. I'm in my shorts. It's going to be a tough sell, but I think I can finish this. The view out the back porch isn't that bad either. I think it's around 12:30 sometime. We're headed back across Imperial Eagle Channel and headed for Jarvis Lagoon. It's only about 7 miles away. Nice little breeze. We've got a reef in the main. The swells are about maybe a meter. The wind's from the west, pure west. Just getting in behind Jarvis Island now. A little gusty in here, so we'll have to watch the rocks. The approach to Jarvis Bay. Lots of rocks and some kayakers in here. Going for a row. It's a lagoon after all. We'll be looking out towards Turtle Island. Well, another day of sailing in Barkley Sound. Just out of Jarvis Bay or Jarvis Lagoon, headed for Ukula. There's a big storm coming in tomorrow. Heavy rain and up to 40 knots of wind. So I think I'll tie to a dock. It seems to be the prudent thing to do. Okay, so the ultimate in selfies. Gotta hang on to something. It's actually not a bad sail. A little chilly. It's not raining. The wind's steady. And like I say, we're coming up to Ukula.
It's Wednesday. The front has arrived. And it is pissing down out there.
Breakfast at lunchtime. Seeing the weather is as crappy as it is, I might as well have a late breakfast. cleaned up. Yeah, we're good. Just gonna be a long day, but I got internet access so I can work and keep a log up and watch YouTube videos. It's all we can do. Well, finally on my way again. And this is why we generally tend to come out here. Sparkling blue sky and sparkling blue water. Back in Turtle Island, or at Turtle Island. Well, it looks pretty empty in here today. You can tell there's lots of wind. It is 1 o'clock. And it's still raining. Aren't we just having fun? Well, it's about, just about 5:30 in the morning. Just left Turtle Island. Doesn't look like much of a swell out here. There is an ugly fog bank ahead, though. We shall see what it's going to be like out there. It's supposed to be not bad, except for the fog report, which is supposed to burn off later. So we'll see. Miss some of these rocks. Should be past the cooler in about an hour. Well, not much to see here, folks. Move along. Pretty pea soup fog. We're 15 miles from Leonard Island. At least the swells aren't big. Well, about a mile and a half off Long Beach. 5 miles to go. Just about ran over a powerboat that was doing something out here. Fortunately, it was on the port side and crossed my bow, so I would have had the right away anyway. But the fog was a little bit thicker back then, so I didn't see him until he was just a move in top of me. Other than that, it's a little chilly, but it's not bad. But it is kind of boring because there's nothing to see except water and gray fog. Close to Leonard Island, right around that point is Fox Bay. And it's just starting to rain a bit, and it's supposed to rain this afternoon and tonight. So I think we're going to go to Tofino and stay there. Barely sun tomorrow. Coming into Tofino. So much for the gloom and doom of rain and wind day. Turned out to be a very nice day. Into the wild blue yonder we go, headed for White Pine Cove, that's where it is. Looks pretty. Well, to say that was exciting was a bit of an understatement. That's about 25 knots of wind on the nose out there. And that's on the way up behind Flores Island. So we'll go to Quiet Bay today and then try again tomorrow morning before the wind really picks up. Even this guy is tucking in behind his head. And well, we're cruising along at almost 7 knots. Now we got current against us and auto is trying to keep up. Just the jib. The main hasn't come up yet. Even in here it's blowing pretty good. And lots of crab traps. They're everywhere. Try to a bit of a raft. A little anchor out here somewhere in the middle. Not particularly crowded. Somebody's abandoned boat. Quite lonely here because there's no one else here. The boat you can see in the background is abandoned. It was here 6 years ago when I was here. It's getting greener. It's already blowing 18 knots where we're going to get around the corner with a low southwesterly swell and a 4 foot chop rough. We got about 45 minutes to go to get to the channel and then theoretically the windy channel, and then theoretically it's about a 45 minute going around the corner thing. That'll be the rough part, but I have my morning coffee. And the sky looks pretty good. And it's supposed to be sunny, so hey, could be worse. We might be forced back into here, but we'll give it a try. Well, it looks much more manageable this morning. Just gotta get around this corner and then we'll be headed in the right direction. Oh, much more agreeable than yesterday. This will be an easy run around the corner. Well, there we are, 7 o'clock in the morning. And we are sailing. Of course it's right on the nose, but what the hell. We're sailing. That'll be Hayden Pass, about 5 miles away. Where we're headed. One of the fish farms here. Actually, not as many as I thought they were. Well, the same as last time. We're sailing along in sheltered inlet. Still going windward. Even though we've turned 90 degrees after Hayden Pass. But so far, it's been a good sail. The reef's back in, and it's been in and out a couple times now. Moving along at about 7 knots. I think it's time to put the camera away. Or it won't get wet. Well, that proved to be a bit of a challenge. Spray all the way back into the cockpit again. Have to take a shower just to get the salt out of my hair. But we are in calm water again. See how busy the docks are.
Okay. apartment? Yeah, this will be fun.
Dog population that they say don't feed. I can understand why. Yes.
You guys good now? It was only a float plane. And these ladies are still practicing as well. Streaming along on Sydney Channel. Nice not to have to go upwind for a change. Been pretty hard to take so far today. And I obviously need to have less coffee in the morning so I can stop the camera from shaking quite that bad. But today is a pretty good day, you have to admit. Haven't been here since 1991. Well, this is the entrance. It looks a lot narrower than it did a couple of these or all those years ago. We've got a flood tide and wind behind us. So we might just zip through. Piece of cake. Funk. Well, the anchor's down. The only boat here, certainly bigger than I remember it. The barbecue is lit. I got Mark's bottle of wine, very tasty. A Rodney Strong Cab, 2014, yeah, very nice. Okay, so this is sailing in the on the west coast, just out of Sydney Channel, or into Sydney Channel, out of Bottleneck Cove. A nice 12 knot breeze across the bow. We're working our way to windward to get into Shelter Inlet. About 3 miles to go to get to that. I got to tack upwind. And then we'll go to Hayden Pass. You can sort of see there's lots of boats here. It'll be a tough swing to find an anchorage. Doesn't get much prettier than that. This will be the view out the aft deck. Pretty tough to take. And there's no one else here. I think it's getting a little shallow. Let's go back to the deep water. It's been a tough day. The sun is finally behind the hill. It's 29 degrees here. Had a nice shower on the foredeck. There's no one else here. Nothing to be shy about. It's finally starting to cool off a bit. The old barbecue is lit as the sun starts to crawl up the mountains. It's tough out here this morning. The sun's up. It's not even 8 o'clock yet. The tide is way out. Not a ripple and not a cloud in the sky. We're going to go to White Pine Cove today. It's about 12, 15 miles from here. Should be a good little sail, and then tomorrow. Today's Saturday. Tomorrow we'll head off to Euculet. Because on Monday there's a chance of more clouds. And we're talking gale force winds all day on Monday. Well, a very nice place and all, but boy does it reek. It's like raw sewage. It's a zero or negative tide this morning, so that's probably why it smells as bad as it does, but it's pretty awful. So we'll go over to Sulphur Passage and maybe drop the hook there. This will be the entrance to the Sulphur Pass. We're just idling along, charging up the batteries. Theoretically, there's a pass in there. Certainly not the widest pass I've ever seen. Of course, it is zero tide, and it is still falling. Well, the wind came in a little late today. It's just around 11 o'clock some time, but it's nice and warm. It doesn't get much better than this. I mean, Miller Channel, we get the White Pine Cove. That's only about 5 miles away at the moment. We're doing 5 knots to windward and light breeze, and it's a nice warm breeze. I got a shirt on because I'm burnt from a couple days ago. Still haven't seen a single boat. Coming into White Pine Cove. And just like that, it's 6:30 and the wind has died. And the temperature's gone up. As another spectacular day comes to an end. It's still 27 degrees out, and I think it's just after 9 o'clock. By 5:15 in the morning, and I'm headed out. It's a beautiful morning. It's not blowing out there yet, and we're still 2 hours from Tofino, and we hit the open ocean. So we got a little ways to go yet. There's not much of a ripple here yet either, but hey. Beggars can't be choosers. We got what we got. Well, the wind has finally come in a little bit. Leonard Island is just beyond that island in front of us, for which I don't have a name. Sails are up. There's still a significant current inbound. That's about 1.5 to 2 knots. But we are sailing. That'll be Schooner Bay with all the resorts. And there is the Leonard Island Lighthouse. As always, the wind's just starting to pick up a little bit. We're running a very broad reach. About 5 miles offshore, not quite that far, I guess 4 miles offshore. And the wind's about 15. Getting a few more white caps out there. It's not all that cold out here. Just that I'm standing in the shade and the wind is a bit cool, so I got the big jacket on. But so far, it's a very pleasant little ride. We're still a long ways from making the dive back into Euculet. In fact, we're still 16 miles from Euculet, or Amphitech Point. But it's a very pleasant day. This will be the Francis Barkley going to Euclid. A bunch of passengers and a bit of freight, I'm sure. Well, just a lovely day sail. Barkley Sound when it's really calm. Nice little southwest breeze, about 7 or 8 knots. Sort of sliding on a broad reach towards the Port Alberni Yacht Club. It's nice and warm. Overdressed. Well, it's 9:30 in the morning, and we're headed off to Port Alberni, the first time the spinnaker's been up. The clouds will burn off, it'll get warm this afternoon. Only 24 miles to go. The sunshine has broken out. We still got 16 miles to go, but the wind has increased a little bit, and it's a great ride so far. It was a bit of a struggle. Got the main down just a jib out. I would imagine it's blowing about 20 now. Lots of white caps. Going on average about 6.5 knots. Whoa! I guess I better tie that down. Just by his prop narrows. Up in this little homestead. And speaking of Sprott Nurls, that'll be it. There's one other place just around the corner here. Just speeding past a logwood. About 3 miles from Port Alberni. Finicky wind. Ah, the big city. Old Port Alberni. The wind's still blowing, but not very hard. I was down to 3 knots. And my rental car is waiting for me. They're even gonna pick me up.